Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my another video, and this video is talking about full stack interviews these days. So what happens is, if company is hiring, what they do is they put their questionnaires on the HackerRank. They even put their exercise. Okay, there is a React exercise, there is an Angular exercise, there is a Node.js exercise on HackerRank, and you have to just get that done by running all the test cases, by writing the code. Always there is a partial code already written. You have to just complete it based on the description that has been given in the problem statement. Okay, so what I'm going to do in this playlist, I'm going to put 3-4 videos which talks about what kind of questions this HackerRank is asking. These questions can be dynamic, but you should be ready. Only the thing is, you have to get all the test cases running. You have to write code in such a way that you should be able to complete the functionality which that question is asking for. Like, even if you do the practice test on the HackerRank about getting certification for React, Angular or Node.js, you will see the same kind of thing. You will see the questions in the README instruction, and you will see some partial code which you can clone it, and locally you can write code and you can push those commits. You just need to make sure that while you are doing npm run test, all the test cases should be passing. So currently, if I have this partial code already cloned, and if I try to run npm run test, then currently my test case will not be passing because I haven't implemented it. Just a pretty much cloned code I just got. So in the README, what we need to build first, let's take a look onto this. So create a basic article sorting application. This is the question which you will see on the HackerRank, and some partial boilerplate code is already there. You just need to write a business logic of getting things done. Like here, most of these header, table, data and everything is there. You just need to write a logic. When you click on upvote, then it should be sorted based on the upvote. When you click on most recent, then it should be sorted based on the most recent data you have, right? And whenever you do npm run test, you should be able to get all the test case passing. Currently these are failing because we haven't written our logic for this. Okay, now let's get started with this. So here what we need to do is, you can also go through this and read it. We already have article data. So we already have article data which we have, like we are getting title, upvote, date. So this data we just need to populate on the UI. Okay, here we can see this HTML table, and once we have the data, we just need to populate it. Populating this data in the table, it's not a big thing. Just getting this sorting done based on these two button clicks. So you will also see this code already written in the app.js. You will see these two buttons are there, because if I run this application live, this is how it looks like currently. Now we just need to write a logic to click onto these buttons and populate data onto this table. And once we see all these things, then our test case will also start passing. Okay, if you just see the README preview, what we need to do is, by default, articles should be displayed in order of number of upvotes in ascending order. So this is the default order which you need to take care of, because the test case, the default test case, if you look at this, these are written based on your README instructions. So if you write the code in that way, then only your test case will pass. Clicking on to most upvote button, it will sort based on the descending order. Clicking on to most recent, we'll do the same thing. Now what you need to do is, you also need to get the data. And how these test cases are written? These test cases are actually using these target IDs to inspect the data. Okay, this data is coming on the top or not. So they are using, just inspecting the DOM, and they are feeding the data. If you look at the test case here, they are feeding the mock data, and they are inspecting, they are rendering, seller rendering the component, and they are inspecting the data, whatever the component is getting rendered. So they are using this testing library. This is what we do for writing the unit test cases. That's not our headache. We just need to get all these test cases running by getting our task done. Okay, so look at the app.js, and this is index.js. Here we have articles, that is good. So we just need to pass it. We are already passing this in the app component. So let's first render this article data. So if we go to app component, we are already getting articles. We are also passing it to the article. This is a pre-written code. We haven't written this. So we are going into the article. Okay, this is the table and we have the data. So what we can do is we can just run a loop, right? Run a loop and can see what data we are getting. So it's a table and we can just do if articles is there and then article dot map we can do simple. article.map and we can just run an array on this dot map. This is how we use to get the item. So this is our item and this is our index. I think we have added one at extra. Okay, now we can just return this tr block inside it. This is how we render the JSX, right? Okay, this is, we are just rendering the content. Let's see what is not correct here. Okay, now we just need to look for the data. So this data contains title, upvote and date, right? So that we are getting here. We can just do key equal to, this would be dynamic. So here we can just pass index and we can just do I.title, I.upvote. We can just see how it is written in the index.js. It's upvotes and date, all in lowercase. So this is our first thing we have done. So let's see we got the data. So this is fine. Now we need to find out how we can do the sorting, and these buttons are already created here. So now we just need to use our basic React skills, okay, that we can just use some kind of filter mechanism, and when these two buttons are clicked we should be able to sort. By default the data should be sorted based on the upvotes and all. Okay, so what we can do, we are already passing the data, so we have to create these two buttons. These two buttons like upvote and recent. So whenever you click onto this, on click, we need to write method here, which is let's say upvoted. On click upvote, we have to define this method, and here we have another method which is recent. Okay, these are, we are writing a functional component, so we can write it as an arrow function. So this is upvote, and we have one more method which is for recent. So I'm not teaching how to write React here. It's just like we need to set some kind of a filter to just pass it to the child component to know what is our current filter status is. So we are using use state. So here is our filter, that filter, we can use state, and in the use state we can initialize our filter with upvote is also false, and these are actually filter having boolean status, that's it. Now when you click on upvote, we just need to toggle this, right? We just need to call set filter, and we need to make upvote true, or we need to make recent true. You can think of any other better way. So here upvote is false, recent is true, and always override on top of your current state. Okay, so we have this filter state in our parent component, and this we need to pass down to our child component so that our table component can be filtered based on your current state, like you're passing filter, then filter contains upvote as a true or recent as a false, and okay, do the sorting based on the upvote, something like this. Let's go to the filter component, and here now we are going to get the filter property also. Okay, now we can't directly use the article data we are directly getting. What we need to do, we also need to do the default sorting. If nothing is provided, there is a default sorting which we can see here, that by default the article should be displayed in table ordered by number of upvotes in descending order. So we have to take care of that, right? So what we can do is, let's go to our article. We got the filter value. So instead of passing this article data directly, we have to do the transformation on this, right? And to do the transformation, let's have another state here, const data, and set data. We can use state hook. Why it is frozen? Okay, so here I'm saying we can have a local state data and set data. This is a local state we have, and let's initialize it with empty array. Now, you know, like parent component will keep sending us the toggle. Sometimes you want upvote, sometimes you want a recent based sorting, right? In that case, we can also use effect hook, and in the use effect we can do the sorting based on whatever the props we are getting from the parent component. And this is the dependency array, and what we are returning, this is the callback which will execute once we are unmounting the component. So we are returning null here in the filter. So this is the filter property, right? So we want to execute this whenever there is a change in the filter object. Like filter object, you want a sorting based on the upvotes, you want a sorting based on the dates. So you will be passing a filter dot upvote. Okay, based on this, I want to execute this, and I want to know the new filter criteria. Okay, so filter dot upvote, if this is true, that means my sorting will be decided based on this. And here we will be using the same logic. We already have a set data, so we can put this, and this data we can use in the articles. Instead of directly passing the articles, we can use this local state. So same goes for if we are doing a sorting based on the filter recent. And if we are not doing based on both of these, then we will just put default else block. This is our default sorting once we are rendering the component, and that will be done based on upvotes. So we have puts a upvotes, this will be based on the dates, right? So we have to convert these dates. So these are actually date properties. We can't just do sorting like that. We have to convert that into the date object. So there is a b.date and a.date. Okay, let's see what's wrong here. This look fine. Okay, so this is just a different ways of sorting. Here we are doing based on the recent upvotes, and you can just need to pass whatever you are using as a dependency. We are using filter object, we are using articles, so we don't get any ESLint errors. Okay, so this is our logic to get the sorting done, and this is it, I guess. Let's see this. Okay, we are able to get this working. By default, it should be sorted based on the upvotes, right? Pretty much straightforward. And now we can just run the test and see. There may be a test cases which might be failing once, but we already have gone through this clearly. Let's see if some test case failed. We should be able to fix that. But these are the minimum criteria we have to satisfy. Okay. So similarly, there can be angular test where you have to write some component. There will be some partial code already written. You have to just write the test case and all. Not test case, you have to write the logic so that your test case can pass. Similarly, there can be a code already written in Node.js. Now we are able to pass all the test case, and you can push this code to the Heroku remote link and you are good. Okay, similarly, let's cover one more exercise for React, Angular and Node.js.